Gaston makes you cry, so please feel free to use the back doors to get away from him. Also, be sure to stay clear of the pathways, because others will be using these pathways.
No, again, my name's not Tuesday.
Yeah, no, oh, I feel like that.
Wait, hello? Hello?
Sorry, I know I'm not supposed to be using my cellular device. Guess we'll shut it off. What are you up to, Belle?
Talk with these finally.
Why, hello. I'm sure you're here to see me, of course. But, you're gonna want to take pictures, but can't. Sorry. Gonna have to wait until after the show, where I'll be in the hallway, and you can take as many pictures as you want of me. Just me. Okay, there'll be others, but mainly me. My line will be the longest.
You're darn right it will be.
This one, I have things to do. So, I'll see you later.
That Belle. Oh, it's playing hard to get. Belle. Oh, Belle.
Once upon a time in a faraway land, a young prince lived in a shining castle. Although he had everything his heart desired, the prince was spoiled, selfish, and unkind. But then one winter's night, an old beggar woman came to the castle and offered him a single rose in return for shelter from the bitter cold. Repulsed by her haggard appearance, the prince sneered at the gift and turned the old woman away. But she warned him not to be deceived by appearances, for beauty is found within. And when he dismissed her again, the old woman's ugliness melted away to reveal a beautiful enchantress. The prince tried to apologize, but it was too late, for she had seen there was no love in his heart. As punishment, she transformed him into a hideous beast and placed a powerful spell on the castle and all who lived there. Ashamed of his monstrous form, the beast concealed himself inside his castle with a magic mirror as his only window to the outside world. The rose she had offered him was truly an enchanted rose, which would bloom for many years. If he could learn to love another and earn their love in return by the time the last petal fell, then the spell would be broken. If not, he would be doomed to remain a beast for all time. As the years passed, he fell into despair and lost all hope. For who could ever learn to love a beast?
Town, it's a quiet village. Every day, like the one. and an ogre and...
That's nice. Marie the Baguette! Hurry up! Finished already?
Oh, I couldn't put it down. Have you got anything new?
Not since yesterday.
That's all right. I'll borrow this one.
That one? But you've read it twice.
Oh, it's my favorite. Far off places, daring sword fights, magic spells, a prince in disguise.
Well, if you like it that much, it's yours.
But sir...
Please, I insist.
Well, thank you. Thank you very much.
There she goes, that girl who's so
behind that bare facade, I'm afraid she's rather odd.
Very different from the rest of us. She's nothing like the rest of us. She's different from the rest of us.
I got it! I got it! I got it! Wow! You didn't miss a shot, Gaston. You're the greatest hunter in the whole world!
I know.
No beast alive stands a chance against you.
And no girl, for that matter.
It's true, Boo, and I got my sights set on that one.
The inventor's daughter?
Yep, she's the one, the lucky girl I'm going to marry.
But she's...
The most beautiful girl in town.
I know, but...
That makes her the best. Don't I deserve the best?
Of course you do!
Right from the moment when I met her, saw her, I said she's gorgeous and I fell. Here in town there's only she. Who is beautiful as me, so I'm making plans to woo and marry Belle. Time you got your head out of these books and start paying attention to more important things.
Hint, hint.
Like you.
Exactly. The whole town's talking about it. It's not right for a girl to read. Soon she starts getting ideas and thinking.
Gaston, you're positively primeval.
Why, thank you, Belle. What do you say we take a trip over to the tavern and look at all my trophies?
What do you say we don't?
Oh, come on, Belle. I think I know how you feel about me.
You can't even imagine. Gaston, please, I have to get inside to help my father.
That crazy old fool. He needs all the help he can get.
Don't talk about my father that way.
talk about her father that way.
My father's not crazy. He's a genius. Papa!
Some genius.
What's a genius?
Now, LeFrew, I want you to go into the woods, get the biggest, healthiest deer you can find.
Anything but the woods. I hate the woods. You know I hate the woods.
Just give me a deer for my wedding feast.
But I hate the woods. It's dark and spooky and there's bugs and spiders.
Papa, are you all right?
Nah, I'm fine. But I can't for the life of me figure out why that happened. This isn't the stubbornest piece of... Ow!
Papa!
I'm about ready to give up on this hunk of junk.
Oh, you always say that.
Well, I mean it this time. I'll never get this boneheaded contraption to work.
Yes, you will. And you win first prize at the fair tomorrow. And become a world-famous inventor.
Do you really think so?
You know I do. I always have.
Well, then we better get to work. This thing's not gonna fix itself. Let's see, where did I leave that dog-legged clincher?
Papa!
Oh. So, did you have a nice time in town today?
I got a new book.
You do love those books.
Well, they take me to wonderful places, where there's adventure and mystery and romance and happy endings. Papa, if I ask you something, will you answer me honestly?
Don't I always?
Do you think I'm odd?
My daughter? Odd. Now, where would you get an idea like that?
I don't know. It's just that, well, people talk.
They talk about me, too. No, I'm not odd, nor you. No family ever saner, except one uncle who, well, maybe let that pass. In all you say and do, you couldn't make it plainer. You are your mother's daughter, therefore you are class.
So I should just accept I'm simply not like them.
They are the common herd, and you can take my word. You are unique, creme de la creme. No matter what you do, I'm on your side. And if my point of view is somewhat misty-eyed, there's nothing clearer in my life than what I wish and feel for you. And that's a lot, no matter what.
No matter what they say, you make me proud. I love the funny way you stand up on the ground.
It's my intention, my invention shows the world out there one day just what we've got, no matter what. Now some may say all fathers just exaggerate,
that every doctor's great.
You are.
And every daughter tends to say her father's tops.
She pulls out all the stops to praise him, and quite rightly. No matter what the pain, we've come this far. I pray that you remain exactly as you are. This really is a case of father knowing best.
And daughter too.
You're never strange.
Don't ever change.
You're all I've got, no matter what. Try.
All right.
Okay, you get the wood. Let's see, yeah. All
yes.
Bobby, you did it. You really did it. You win first prize at the fair tomorrow. I know it.
Who knows? Maybe I will at that.
Oh, I almost forgot. I made you a scarf for good luck.
Oh, now I know I'll win. And then I'll take you to all those places you've read about in your books. Well, I'm off.
Goodbye, Papa.
Bye-bye, Belle.
Be careful.
Prize is nearly mine. It's quite my best invention. So simple yet complex, so massive yet so small. This triumph of design shall be my old age pension. That is, provided I can find the fair at all. I must have missed a sign. I should have paid attention. Drat! It's not a nightingale, not a mating call. Wolves! Need a place to stay for the night.
Poor fellow. Oh, Cogsworth, have a heart. Monsieur, you are welcome here.
I heard that. Well, thank you to step out to where I can see you.
Hello. And goodbye.
Wait, you're a clock. And you're talking.
Astonishing, isn't it? And quite inexplicable. Now, goodbye.
Oh, Cogsworth, I'm surprised at you. What are your manners?
We have got to get him out of here before the master finds out.
This is incredible. How is this accomplished?
Really, sir, if you just... Oh! Stop it! Stop it! Really, sir! Do you mind?
Oh, well, I'm stumped. Maybe it's some kind of newfangled scientific gadget.
I, sir, am not a gadget!
Oh, I don't mean to be rude. It's just that I've never seen a talk. A talk. A talk!
Bless you.
Oh, you're chilled to the bone, monsieur. Come, warm yourself by the fire.
No, as head of this household, I forbid it. Oh, not the master's chair. I'm not seeing this. I'm not seeing this.
Ooh la la. What have we here? Do my eyes deceive me, or is this a man? It's been so long since I've seen a real man. No offense, Lemire. Bonjour, Monsieur. Mind if I sit here?
Hello.
I'm head of this household, and this has gone far enough.
Coming through.
Oh, Mrs. Potts.
How would you like a nice pot of tea, sir, to warm you up in no time?
Oh, yes, please.
No. No tea. He'll be here all night. No tea.
There you are.
This is just what I needed.
I think I scared him.
Oh, hey there, little fella. What's your name?
Jip.
Figures.
Careful, blanket, Monsieur. I just love older men.
Oh, Pophead. You are always trying to make me jealous.
Me? What about you? With Simone?
Oh, Jacques.
Michel?
Pierre?
Veronique?
Lumiere, follow me. But do you have any idea what the master will do if he finds out we let a stranger in?
Calm yourself, Cogsworth. The master will never... see. He's bound to find out sooner or later.
Should we hide, Mama?
No. There's no reason to hide. There's no reason to panic.
Lumi is right. There's absolutely no reason to panic. Excuse me. May I borrow this?
There's a stranger here.
Oh, Master, allow me to explain. The gentleman was sent upon war.
Who let him in?
Master, may I take this opportunity to say, I was against him from the start.
Who dared disobey me?
Dear.
You've all betrayed me. Who are you?
Maurice.
What are you doing in my castle?
I lost my way in the woods.
You're not welcome here.
I'm sorry. I'll just be on my way.
It's hideous, isn't it?
Oh, no, I didn't mean it.
So you've come to stare at the beast, have you?
No, I was just looking for a place to stay.
I'll give you a place to stay. Ah! Massaging my feet while the little ones play on the floor with the dogs. Oh, we'll have 6 or 7.
Dogs?
No, Belle. Strapping boys. Like me.
Imagine that.
I can see that we will share all that love implies. We shall be the perfect pair, rather like my thighs. Go face to face with destiny. in life are all's well that ends with me. Escape me, there's no way as certain as Dore. Belle, will you marry? So, Belle, what'll it be? Is it a yes or is it? Oh, yes.
I just don't deserve you.
Who does? Me!
Thanks for asking. So, how did it go?
Oh, you know that, though. She's always playing hard to get.
She turned you down?
For now, but I'll have Belle as my wife. Make no mistake about that.
Well, gee, if she turned you down, maybe I still have a chance.
Get out of my way!
Ow! Stop it! No, no, you don't! He's mine! Ah, I love him!
Is he gone? Can you imagine? He asked me to marry him. Me, the wife of that whorish, brainless. Madame Gaston, can't you just see it? Madame Gaston, his little wife, no, sir, not me. I guarantee it, I want much more than this provincial life. I want to venture in the great wide somewhere. I want it more than I can tell. What's my regret? Someone understand. I want so much more than they've got planned.
Hey, Belle, have you seen Gaston?
He just missed him. Wait a minute, where did you get that scarf?
This? In the woods. Pretty nice, huh?
This belongs to my father.
Yeah, well, finders keepers.
LeFou, I want you to think hard and tell me exactly where you found that.
No!
Think.
In the woods.
Harder.
In the crossroads, okay? Ow.
And he's still out there somewhere. LeFou, you have to take me back.
Not the woods again.
You see? Something must have happened. You have to take me back.
Not on your life.
And I'll find him myself.
Quiet, could we? Just had to invite him to stay, didn't we? Serve him tea. Let him sit in the master's chair.
Oh, I was trying to be hospitable.
Rubbish!
Ah, oh, Cogsworth, can you blame me for trying to maintain what's left of our humanity?
Look at us.
Look at you.
What about me?
You always were insufferable. But every day you just become a little more inflexible. A little more tightly wound. A little more ticked off.
Please. Spare me the stupid puns.
At least we are not as far gone as some others. You saw what happened to me, Shannon?
Oh, she was always too vain about her looks and exactly what she's become.
A vanity.
A mere little draws the whole works.
And poor Jean-Claude.
Who?
Jean-Claude. You know him.
Not too bright, as a brick?
Oh, yes, the old one.
Jean-Claude's a brick wall.
Oh, yes, that's him in the kitchen, behind the stove.
Oh.
And you know Guillaume, the houseboy?
Oh, that mealy little mouth bootlicker! I never liked him. He's always groveling at the master's feet.
He's a doormat.
Oh, perfect.
It's happening faster with the others. But we are not far behind. Slowly but surely, as every day passes, we all gradually become things.
But why did we have to get drug in this whole spell business? It's not like we threw that old beggar poor woman out her ear.
Well, no. But are we responsible too? For making him the way he is?
I suppose so.
All I know is, I will eventually melt away to nothing. I only hope the master has something in store for me if he ever breaks his spell.
We've got to hold on, old man. We've got to hold on.
Hello? Is anyone here? Hello?
It's a girl.
Yes, I know, it's a girl.
Oh, it's a girl! Mademoiselle!
No, Lumiere! I should do most of the
household. Just a word. That's all I'm asking for.
Mama, you're not going to believe what I saw. Not in a million thousand years. Not in a trillion million thousand years.
Yes, Chip.
No, really. It's the greatest thing. It's a thing everybody's been waiting for since... I don't know when.
All right, Chip, what is it?
There's a girl in the castle.
Bless my soul, wouldn't that be lovely?
But there is. I saw her.
Now, Chip, I'll not have you making up such wild stories and getting everyone's hopes up for no reason.
Mrs. Potts, did you hear? There's the girl in the castle.
See, I told you, and she's real pretty, too.
Well, I don't know about that.
Oh, this is the one. The girl, she has come to break the spell.
Wait a minute, let's not be hasty.
Oh. Isn't this wonderful? After all these years. Oh, happy, happy.
No, 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 stop it! Stop that!
We should tell the others, no?
Yes, I mean, wait a minute! Why are you running? Stop it, please, stop!
Hello? Is anyone here? Please, I'm looking for my father.
Belle, is that you?
Papa!
How did you find me here?
Oh, your hands are like ice. We have to get you out of here.
You must leave this place, quickly.
Who's done this to you?
There's no time to explain. You need to go, now.
I won't leave you here. Who's there? I know someone's there. Who are you?
The master of this castle.
Then you're the one who's responsible for this. Release my mother
at once. I am the master of this castle. I do not take orders from anyone. Throw her out.
No way. Forgive me. Please let him out. Can't you see he's not well?
Then he should not have trespassed.
But he's an old man! He could die!
He came into my home uninvited, and now he'll suffer the consequences.
Please, I'll do anything!
Belle, there's nothing you can do.
Wait, please!
I said there's nothing you can do.
Take me instead!
No! What did you just say?
Take me instead.
Belle, you don't know what you're doing. You would do that. You would take his.
If I did, would you let him go?
Yes. But you must promise to stay here forever. No!
Forever?
Forever, or he dies in the dungeon.
That's not fair. Wait. Come into the light.
Make your choice. Belle, listen to me. I'm old, and I've lived my life.
You have my word.
Done!
Spare my daughter.
Take him to the crossroads.
Wait, Belle. No, not yet.
Let her go. Let her go.
Papa!
Master. Master, please. That girl's gonna be with us for some time. You might want to offer her more comfortable.
Didn't let me say goodbye.
What?
I'll never see him again. I didn't even get to say goodbye.
I'll show you to your room.
My room, but I thought...
Do you want to stay in this dungeon?
No.
Then follow! You follow me! This is your home now. You're free to go anywhere you like except for the West Wing.
Why? What's in the West?
It's forbidden! Do you understand? Do! You understand?
Yes.
This is your room. I hope you'll be happy. If you need anything at all, my servants will attend you. And one last thing. You will join me for dinner. And that is not a request!
Yes, I made the choice. For Papa, I will stay. But I don't deserve to lose my freedom in this way. You monster! If you think that what you've done is right, well then, you're a fool. Think. Is this where I should learn to be happy? But when we grow old, home should be where the heart is. Never were words so true. My heart's far, far away. Home is true. Why I'd give to return to the life that I knew lately, and to think I complained of that dull provincial town. Is this home? Am I here for a day or forever? Shut
to make the world seem a bit brighter.
You're
Mrs. Potts, dear, very pleased to make your acquaintance.
Careful, darling.
Who are you?
Madame de la Grande Bouche. Perhaps you've heard of me.
Sorry.
You see, and all about me, one can be, and I quote, the toast of Europe, the brightest star to grace the stage, but fall under one little spell.
Wait, this is impossible.
I know it is, but here we are. Now, what shall we dress you in for dinner? This is nice, but how would you like to wear one of my gowns? Let me see what I've got in my drawer. Whoopsie! Here we are. I wore this the night I performed at the Royal Opera. The king himself was there. Of course, I wouldn't have a prayer fitting into it now. Take it.
That's very kind of you, but I'm not going to dinner.
Don't be silly. Of course you are. You heard what the master said.
He may be your master, but he's not mine. I'm sorry. This is just happening so fast.
It's a very brave thing you did, my dear.
We all think so.
I'm going to miss my papa so much.
Cheer up, child. I know things may seem bleak right now, but you mustn't despair. I hate to see you through. I hope that we'll be friends, though I don't know you well. Anyone can make the most of living here in Belle. It's you and who knows, you may find home here too.
She is. That girl is tangled with the wrong man.
Darn right.
Dismissed. Rejected. Publicly humiliated. It's more than I can bear.
More beer?
What's the use? Nothing helps. I'm disgraced.
Who, you? Never. Gaston, you've got to pull yourself together. Gosh, it disturbs me to see you, Gaston, looking so down in the dumps. Every guy here'd like to be you, Gaston. Even when taking your lumps, there's no man in town as admired as you. Your very hard to see why. No one's slick as Gaston, no one's quick as Gaston, no one's neck's as incredibly thick as Gaston. So there's no man in town half as manly, perfect of pure paragon. You can ask any Tom, Dick, or Stanley, and they'll tell you whose team they'd prefer to be on. No one's been like Gaston, a kingpin like Gaston. No one's got a swell cleft in his chin like Gaston.
As a specimen, yes, I'm intimidating.
I want a guy like Gaston. Give 5, hurrah! Give 12, hip, hip! Gaston is the best in the rest of his old trip.
Ow!
In a wrestling match, nobody bites like Gaston!
See, I got biceps to spare.
Not a bit of him scraggly or scrawny.
That's right. And every last inch of me's covered with hair.
But Gaston matches wits like Gaston. In a spitting match, nobody spits like Gaston.
Surely good at expectorating. When I was a lad, I ate 4 dozen eggs every morning to help me get large. And now that I'm grown, I eat 5 dozen eggs. Now I'm growing the size of a mug. I'm afraid I've been thinking
A dangerous pastime?
I know. When that wacky old coot is Belle's father, and his sanity's only so-so. Now the wheels in my head have been turning since I looked at that loony old man. See, I promised myself I'd be married to Belle, and right now I'm evolving a plan. If I...
Yes?
Then we...
No, would she?
Yes.
Now I get it. Let's go.
No one.
Plots like Gaston.
Pitch him shots like Gaston. Let that perfect
promise back pop like Gaston.
Yes, I'm endlessly wild and resourceful.
As down to the depths you descend.
I won't even be mildly remorseful.
Just as long as you get what you want in the end.
Who has brains like Gaston?
Entertains like Gaston.
Who can make up these endless refrains like Gaston? So his marriage we soon will be celebrating. Oh my, what a guy, Gaston.
What is it?
Is dinner ready, Mrs. Potts?
Oh, just about. I have the slightest idea what she likes to eat, so I've cooked up everything in the kitchen.
Oh, good! But don't just stand there gaping, get back to work.
You tell him.
I can't.
Tell me what?
Oh, don't freak out or anything, but... You've got something on your back!
What on earth are you talking about? What? What is that thing?
It appears to be... a winding handle of sorts.
Well, get it off of me! Ow! Stop it! Stop that!
It won't come off!
What do you mean it won't come off? It wasn't on me last night when I went to bed. Why is this happening to me?
It's the spell, I'm afraid.
Just try to relax.
Relax? Relax? How can I relax with this appendage on my back? Is there no dignity left for me? What's going to go next? My mind?
Oh, Cogswell, it'll be all right.
I'm frightened, Lumiere.
I know, but you're not alone.
We're all in this together.
It's time for dinner. Where is she?
I should go see about her. It won't be a minute.
I told her to come down. What's taking so long?
Try to be patient, sir. The poor girl has lost her father and her freedom all in one day.
Master, have you perhaps thought that this girl could be the one to break the spell?
Of course I have. I'm not a fool.
Oh, good. She falls in love with him. He falls in love with her, and boom, we'll be human again by midnight.
Lumiere, it's not that easy. These things take time.
But we don't have time. Then Rose has already begun to wilt.
It's no use. She's so beautiful and I'm... Well, look at me!
Oh, he has a point.
Master, you have to help us see past all that.
I don't know how.
Well, you could start by trying to make yourself more presentable. Straighten up and try to act like a gentleman.
Impress her with your rapier wit.
But be gentle.
Shower her with copper.
But be sincere and above all.
What?
You must control your temper.
Well?
What?
Where is she?
Who?
The girl.
Oh, yes, the girl. Well, actually, with circumstances being what they are, she's not coming. She's not coming.
What did you just say?
She's not coming.
We'll see about that. Stand where you are, Lumiere, stand aside.
Your lordship, your grace, your eminence, let's not be hasty.
I thought I told you to come down to dinner.
I'm not hungry.
You're hungry if I tell you you're hungry.
Don't be ridiculous.
What did you say?
You can't go around ordering people to be hungry. It doesn't work like that.
I can.
Besides, it's rude.
Rude, is it? Then how about this? If you don't come down to dinner, I will drag you out like
that. Master, that may not be the best way to win the girl's affections.
Please, attempt to be a gentleman.
But she's being so difficult. Why are you being so difficult?
Why are you being such a bully?
Because I want you to come to dinner!
So, you admit you're being a bully.
Deep breath, Master, deep breaths.
I'll ask one last time. Okay. Would you be so kind as to join me for dinner?
Please.
No, thank you.
Fine, then starve!
Oh, master!
If she doesn't eat with me, she doesn't eat at all.
Right. What were we thinking? We will never be human again.
So to be us.
Well, what would you two have us do? Give up? I can't give up until I hear the sound of my boy's laughter as he runs through these holes again.
Quite right, Mrs. Potts. We mustn't give it up while there's still a chance. Lumiere, stand watch and inform me of the slightest change.
Holy, mon capitaine.
What does she want me to do? Beg? Show me the girl.
I know the master can be temperamental, but underneath all that matter, he's not such a bad fellow. Why don't you give him a chance?
Why should I? Did he give my father a chance?
Well, no, but once you get to know him...
I don't want to get to know him. I don't want to have anything to do with him.
It's no use. She'll never see anything in me but a monster. How must this go on? This cruel trick of fate. I simply made one careless wrong decision. And then that witch was gone and left me in this state, an object of revulsion and derision. Hated. Is there one who can show me how to win the world's forgiveness? No! What did they say? Shower her with compliments. Impress her with your wit. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentle man.
Lumiere.
Oh, Babette, come to me, my little flush.
It's my hand, isn't it? Oh, you don't love me anymore. Oh, it's this horrible, horrible spell.
Ah, Sherry, cut me to the wick. Do you think a little thing like that could change my feelings for you?
Now you really tickle my fence.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes.
Oh, no, no. I've been burnt by you before.
Oh,
I got you. Actually, madam, I am a little hungry.
I'll ring Mrs. Potts for you and sing you an aria while we wait. Let it go, let it go.
That's all right. I'll go myself.
The master's really not going to like this.
I know.
Oh dear, oh dear.
I like this girl. I like her spunk.
Well, if you ask me, she's just being stubborn. After all, he did say please.
I think that may be the first time I've heard him use that word.
I believe you're right.
You see, she's already beginning to have a good influence on him.
Oh, here she comes right now.
Oh, there you are, dear. Glad to see you out and about.
I'm Cogsworth, head of this household.
Oh, Cogsworth! I swear! My eyes! They never let the girl and she...
Oh. This is Lumiere.
Oh, j'en mademoiselle. Oh, yes.
Stop it! Stop that! There are children in this audience. If there's anything we can do to make your stay any more comfortable, anything at all.
I am a little hungry.
Except that.
Cogsworth.
Well, you heard what the master said.
Pish posh, I'm not about to let the poor child go hungry.
Fine. Crust of bread, water, and then...
Oh, Cogsworth, I'm surprised at you. She's not our prisoner. She's our guest.
All right. Dinner, but keep it down. If the master finds out, it'll be our next.
Oh, of course, of course. But what's dinner without the little music?
Music?
Monsieur, mademoiselle. It is with my deepest pride and greatest pleasure that we welcome you tonight. Now we invite you to relax. Let us put up a chair. As our dining room proudly presents your dinner.
Oh.
Our guest, be our guest, put our service to the test. Tie a napkin round your neck, Sherry, and we'll provide the rest. Soup de jour at hors d'oeuvres, while we only live to serve. Try the gray stuff.
It's delicious.
Don't believe me, ask the dishes. They can sing, they can dance. After all this is France, and the
well done, well done. Oh my goodness, look at the time, off to bed.
Oh, I couldn't possibly go to bed now. This is my first time in an enchanted castle.
Enchanted castle? Who said anything about the castle being enchanted? It was you, wasn't it?
I figured it out for myself. I'd like to look around, if that's all right.
Oh, perhaps you'll light the door.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm not sure that's such a good idea. We can't have you-know-who go poking around you-know-where, if you know what I mean.
Perhaps you'd like to take me. I'm sure you know everything there is to know about the castle.
You hear this? Well, actually, I do. May I draw your attention to our hand-painted ceilings, complete with cherubs, frolicking in delight, amidst the nymphs and centaurs.
Act like a gentleman. Act like a gentleman. This should be good. Belle, oh Belle.
Now, if you will note the unusual inverted archways, this is yet another example of the late neoclassic Baroque period. And as I always say, if it's not Baroque, don't fix it. Oh, it gets me every time. May I draw your attention to our flying buttresses above the aviary?
Lumiere, it's all so beautiful. I had no idea. If only he weren't here.
Oh, Belle. I'm just fooling myself.
And thanks to some quick thinking on my part, the disaster was averted, and that was the last time any stone of that weight was ever quarried in this area.
What's up there?
Nothing! Nothing of all of any interest in the West Wing.
Ah, so that's the West Wing.
Nice going.
I wonder what he's hiding up there.
Hiding! What an excellent idea! Hiding!
Then it wouldn't be forbidden, would it?
Perhaps Mademoiselle would like to see something else. We have exquisite tapestries dating all the way back to the Aloysius Nepotitius.
Maybe later.
Or perhaps you'd like to see the garden or the library.
You have a library?
Oh, with books. With scads of books, mountains of books, cascades, cloudbursts, forests of books.
Oh, books with pictures, books with words.
Books with so many words you can ever read in a lifetime.
And every author is a panda puppy.
Oh, yes. So many books.
Don't touch that!
I'm sorry.
What are you doing?
Hi.
I thought I told you never to come here.
I know, but...
Do you realize what you could have done?
No.
Get out! You have no right to be there. No right!
Don't touch me!
No, I...
Promise to no promise. I won't stay here.
No, please. You don't understand. There's so little time left.
Cheaper, no power on earth if I can't love her. No passion could reach me, no lesson could teach me how I could have loved her and make her love me too. If I can't love her, then who? Long ago I should have seen all the things I could have been. Careless and unthinking, I moved onward. No pain could be deeper, no life could be cheaper. If I can't love her, no spirit could win me, no hope left within me. Oh, I could have loved her, and that she'd set me free. But it's not me if I can't love her. Let the world be done with me.
She has.
I can't take it anymore.
Oh, what's the matter, Bobby?
This box doesn't cook anymore.
You're acting like the beast.
Babette, eat a Snickers. You get a little feisty when you're hungry.
Better?
Better.
Be sure to avoid the beast of hunger.
You should go to the concession stands during intermission.
We will now have a 15-minute intermission.
Thank you.
that. Just hold still.
Ow! That hurts!
If you hold still, it won't hurt as much.
If you hadn't run away, this wouldn't have happened.
If you hadn't frightened me, I wouldn't have run away.
Well, you shouldn't have been in the West Wing.
And you should learn to control your temper. Now hold still. Just be still a little. By the way, thank you for saving my life.
You're welcome.
Well, that's more like it. I knew they could get along if they tried.
So the ice is broken at last.
And not a moment too soon either. Have you taken a good look at the rose lately? It's losing petals at an alarming rate.
Not to mention the fact that I can hardly bend over at all anymore.
Well, clearly it's time we give them a little push. We need to find a nice, romantic way to draw them closer together.
I have just the thing. How about we warm you two up a bit with a nice bowl of soup?
Soup?
Trust me.
There's something sweet and almost kind. But he was mean, he was coarse and unrefined. But now he's dear and so unsure. I wonder why he didn't sit there before. Cheers.
Come along, dear. Let's get you out of those wet things.
She glances away. I thought I saw when we touched in the shuttle at my bar. But Henry, I'll just ignore. But then she's never looked at me before. She smiles at me. My heart starts pounding and I can't breathe.
I'm good.
That's good.
Oh, it's excellent.
I never felt this way about anything. Why don't you do something? What?
Well, you can give her the usual things as chocolates, flowers, promises you don't in the heat.
No. This is no ordinary girl. This is a special girl. You need to do something that sparks her interest. Something that... Oh!
What? Your shirt.
Oh, here she can wait.
Well,
say something about the dress.
It's pink.
A compliment.
What a nice dress.
Thank you.
Well, here's something to show them. But first, you have to close your eyes. It's a surprise.
But the girl? Just wait till you see what he takes her.
They're so cute together.
Quite proud of him, actually.
Maybe this is our chance. Just wait till you see where he takes her.
Hope the spell breaks. Can't bend over.
Don't we all?
I don't want to hear it from you.
What do they got?
Thank you.
not.
Well, bless my soul.
Well, who'd have known?
Well, who indeed?
And who'd have guessed they'd come together on their own?
It's so peculiar.
Wait and see. A few days more. There may be something there that wasn't there before.
Perhaps there's something there that wasn't there before.
What?
There may be something there that wasn't there before.
What's there, Mama?
I'll tell you when you're older.
Mama?
Yes, Chip?
Will I ever get to be a boy again?
I hope so.
When will I know?
Soon. If it's to be, it'll be very soon now. Come along, let's give them some privacy.
Knowing not that this was a legendary sword called Excalibur, Arthur tried to pull it from the stone. He tried once, to pull it out. He tried a second time, but still he could not pull it out. Then, for the third time, Arthur drew forth the sword.
So that must mean he's the king!
Wait and see.
I didn't know books could do that.
Do what?
Yes!
Thank you for coming on such short notice, Monsieur de Arc.
I don't usually leave the asylum this late at night, but this fella, he said you'd make it worth my while.
Well, you see, I got my heart set on marrying Belle, but she needs a little persuasion.
Turned him down flat.
It's like this. See? There's a danger I'll be thwarted and denied my honeymoon. For the pretty thing I've courted refuses to swoon. So the time has come for a murky plan, for which I turn to a murky man.
To find that fiend where better
than
the Maison de Rue.
I don't take this girl for granted. There's no path I don't see. I'm planted, no flowers are true. But quite amazing to relate, she doesn't want me for her mate.
Which forces him to contemplate the Maison de Rue.
I don't wish to seem a tad obtuse, but I don't see how I can be of use. For I lock people up, I'm not a lonely hearts club. I'm a cold, cold fish. I'm a nasty, vicious streak.
Please, speak.
It's Belle's father who's your client. She adores the old buffoon. She'll be forced to be compliant.
She'll dance to your tune.
We get the daughter through her dad. You just pronounced the old boy mad.
And will she land up in your bag?
The Maison de Rue. I make myself entirely clear. It's the simplest deal of my whole foul career. But Maurice away and she'll be here in moments. In a dreadful state, she'll capitulate to me.
She'd rather die than have her daddy
ossify in my sordid saloon. So book the church race glasses high to the Maison.
I'm not sure I can do that.
You must.
You care for the girl, don't you?
More than anything.
Then why not tell her?
I can't.
You must.
Master, there'll be beautiful music. A romantic candlelight provided by myself. And when the moment is right...
How will I know when the moment is right?
You'll feel slightly nauseous.
What?
No. You will know because you will be able to hear. You must speak from the heart.
I must speak from... I can't.
You must.
What are you afraid of?
Nothing.
Master.
I'm afraid she might...
She might what?
Laugh at me.
Somehow, my prince, you must find the courage to take that chance.
Master, look. We have little to no time left.
Here. This is my most dear courage.
Look, Master. You can do this.
I know you can. Take it.
Master.
this time. True as it can be. Barely even friends, then somebody bends unexpectedly. Just a little change, small to say the least, both a little scared, neither one prepared. Beauty and the Beast.
Dance with me.
No, I
don't dance with her. Dance.
Ever just the same, ever a surprise, ever as before, ever just as sure as the sun will rise. Feel as old as time, tune as old.
Asking me to dinner.
Dinner was delicious.
Belle, are you happy here?
Oh, yes. Everyone's so kind. Mrs. Potts, Lumiere.
With me?
Yes.
Belle, speak from
the heart.
What's wrong?
I was just thinking about my father. I miss him so much. I wish I could see him again.
There is a way. Come with me. This mirror, it will show you anything you wish to see.
I'd like to see my father, please. Papa! Oh no, Papa, he's in the woods. I think he's lost. He should.
Go to him.
What about?
You're not my prisoner anymore, and you haven't been for some time. Take it with you, so you always have a way to look back and remember me.
I could never forget you.
Belle, I...
Yes?
Go! 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 I'll never see her again.
Well, Saya, I must say, everything is just going swimmingly. I knew you had it in you.
I let her go.
You what?
Could you do
it? I had to!
But why?
After all this time, he's finally learned to love.
That's it then. I should break the spell.
It's not enough. She has to love him in return.
Now it's too late. Come on, Lumi.
No pain could be deeper. No life could be cheaper. Loved her and make her love me too. No hope she would do so, no dream to. So I look to myself, despite all the things I see, for I know that she cannot set
family home. Rest here.
I don't know what happened. The last thing I remember is falling.
You're in the woods, Papa. I thought I'd never find you.
But the beast, how did you escape?
I didn't escape. He let me go.
He let you go? That terrible beast.
He's not terrible. In the beginning, I was so frightened. I thought it was the end of everything. But somehow, things changed.
How?
I don't know, but when I look around, I see the whole world differently. There's been a change in me, a kind of moving on. The what I used to be, I still depend upon. For now I realize that good can come from bad. That may not make me wise, but oh, it makes me glad. And I never thought I'd leave behind my childhood dreams, but I don't mind. For now, I love the world I see. No change of heart, a change of
raving like a lunatic. We all heard him, didn't we?
Yeah!
Come on quietly now.
You can't do this.
Tell us again, old man. Just how big was that beast?
Well, he was at least 8. No, more like 10 feet tall.
You don't get much crazier than that.
It's true, I tell you. Hey, let go of me.
Tell me, Maurice, when did you start having these delusions?
It's not a delusion. The beast was real, and so was the talking clock.
Poor Belle, it's a shame about your father.
Gaston, you know he's not crazy.
I might be able to clear up this misunderstanding if...
If what?
You'll marry me.
What?
One word, Belle, that's all it takes.
Never!
Have it your way! Take the old man!
Wait! I can prove my father's not crazy. Show me the beast!
That's him! That's him!
No, he never hurt anyone. I know he looks frightful, but he's really kind and gentle. He's my friend.
If I didn't know any better, I'd say you have feelings for this monster.
He's not the monster, Gaston. You are.
She's as crazy as the old man. She says this creature is her friend. Well, I've hunted wild beasts, and I've seen what they can do. We'll make off with their children. We'll come after them in the night.
He would never do that.
Forget the old man. I say, we kill the beast.
Yeah!
set to sacrifice our children to his monstrous appetite.
He'll wreak havoc on our village if we let him wander free!
So it's time to take some action, boys. It's time to follow me.
Through the mist, through the wood, through the darkness and the shadows, it's a nightmare, but it's one exciting ride. Say a prayer, then we're there. With the drawbridge of the castle, you see something truly terrible inside. It's a beast, he's got fangs, razor sharp claws, massive paws, killer claws for the feast. Hear him roar, see him foam, but we're not coming home till he's dead. Good and dead, kill the beast.
I won't let you do this.
Try and stop us.
Papa, this is all my fault. I have to go back and warn him.
I'm coming with you.
No.
I already lost you once, and I'm not going to lose you again.
Let's rid the village of this beast. Who's with me? Courage to the sticky place.
Counting on your stones will lead the way.
Through a mist, through a wood, where we see the ones in castles, something something that she knows the every day.
It's a beast, one as tall as a mountain. We will rest till he's good in his seat. Sally boys, sally ho, grab your sword, grab your bow. It's a morning, here we go.
We don't know why, what we don't understand. In fact, it scares us in this monster.
You can find. But remember, the beast is mine!
Hearts ablaze, banners high, we go marching into battle, unafraid of the dangers just increase. Raise the flag, sing a song, here we come, we're fit and strong, and we can thirst and can be wrong. Kill the beast! Kill the beast!
Belle!
I'm sorry.
came back. You came back.
Of course I came back. I couldn't let them. If only I'd come sooner.
Maybe it's better this way.
Don't talk like that. Everything will be fine.
No.
Shh. We're together now. You'll see.
At least I got to see one last.
I